wind motion can be described by angular clamping. And then the other mass is moving linearly. It can be described using a displacement x. Okay? So if you're going to do analysis, you're going to do it by divide and conquer. Okay. So what to do next? First, if you're going to divide, okay, I will first divide them, okay, into a rod itself, okay, spring supported, okay, get the end of the spring supported, okay, this is ground, no motion, the other end, motion is x, okay, if you now make a turn, okay, theta, so this motion is L theta at pitch. The midspan will move half L theta. Okay? So as such, what are the forces acting on these rocks? Okay, there are two forces. The first force is the tip spring force, which is K1 L theta minus 0. The other force is the midspan spring that opposed the motion. How much is the opposition of the spring force? It's K2 half L theta minus F. Okay. Why do I always have L theta first? It's because my viewpoint is always in the direction of my motion. So if I move clockwise, inducing a downward displacement, there will be always opposing upward motion. So in this way, you've got to do the moment summation, okay, to find the Newton second law, okay? So that moment, got moment arm being half L, got moment arm being L, so in that way, you can write the equation, okay? This, that is your starting point to get your natural frequency and the motion. The expression will be complex, that's why in the current question you are asked to test for the number. Okay, with this we are done with the tutorial.